Greetings OPV 2210. As a group, our chosen topic is inclusive education. I'll start by defining what an inclusive education is. Inclusive education alludes the joining of understudies with extraordinary necessities, otherwise called inabilities, into standard schooling. It advances that variety ought to be seen as an asset to help with learning. Comprehensive instruction is centered around the plan and advancement of our schools, homerooms, projects, and exercise so all students can get to and connect together. Okay, in inclusive education, we'll be discussing the principles of inclusive education and how are we going to implement those principles in the classroom. Okay, the first principles that we chose to use is the diversity in the classroom enriches and strengthens education. We will use this principle, which we'll be using a multicultural approach, to make sure that the learners feel safe and be respected, as we believe that this will encourage diversity and acceptance. Ultimately, the studies show that variety in schooling, especially on school grounds, work on the scholarity commitment, self-inspiration, citizenship and social commitment, and scholastic abilities like decisive reasoning, critical thinking, and composing for understudies, all things considered. This will help the learners to engage and be accommodated in classroom activities.
So now let's continue with the principles of inclusive education and implementation in the classroom. Number two, we have inclusive teachers that need commitment, knowledge, and practical skills. I will communicate with learners that have unclear speech by the use of pictures, learning charts, and drawn symbols. I will put them on the wall or in the chalkboard. Then the learners will be asked to point pictures. They will do that in order for me to know what do they want and in order for me to pass the message to them or the response. Now let's look at our last part of principles of inclusive education and implementation in the classroom. Number three, we have student engagement, agency, and voice. This is where we allow students to work in groups and do group discussions or engage in debates. I believe that this will aid students to fully engage and develop stronger communication skills. Since we have some students who are introverts, so this will go a long way. It will also refine understanding through discussion and help them break complex tasks into parts and steps.